motherfucking do? I asked you all a question! As I reveal my giant monkey! That's not as funny as you thought it was, boy!
God, I thought he meant penis!
I swear, the only thing I hate more than weaklings... Hey! I'm speaking, soldier! Don't fucking speak unless you're smart, you fucking nerd! What we're gonna do is we're gonna fly over the nerd!
The talk show at the end of the week.
Space is big.
Star Citizen Base.
It's really big.
Round table.
Gentrified as soldiers.
How do we now?
Yeah. As soldiers.
All right, welcome to the round table, everybody. We're back.
Uh-oh.
Good start.
Look at that beautiful, start, beautiful capsule in the water there.
It floats.
Of course just it does. Tip. It's just a tip, yeah.
Yay!
Yeah.
Is it just a peak?
Yeah, about 500 meters below the surface as well.
There's a giant spaceship on the water.
The aliens will come in to land it.
Where the hell is their crane recovery ship?
That's what's on. That's what the camera's on. They're heading over towards it now.
They're doing them. They're approaching with. What did they explain it like? They're approaching with. They're first going to assess if it's safe, so that it's not leaking something that it would explode. If it's safe, then they'll bring people in to go in and assess them medically, the astronauts?
No. They were going to put the rigging on the top of the capsule so that they can use the crane to pull it into the ship.
Not before they've been tested medically.
What, to see if they have space herpes?
Yeah. Or Corona came from space, maybe.
Does the capsule have a LTI?
I don't think it does.
Yeah, I don't think it. I don't think they're going to reuse that one.
Where's that big stain on the top there? What is that?
It looks like it's burnt.
No, really?
A little bit. I'm sure it was hot as fuck coming back.
It was so clean when they...
Probably a big bird went by and just pooped on it.
Well, who knows what it hit on the way back in.
No, I'm guessing it's probably... At the top is where the parachute pops out, or near the top. So that's probably.
Parachute's already gone.
Pyrotechnics would occur there. But it's probably just re entry damage.
So, how much damage are we doing to the ecosystem by fucking having these splashdowns?
I think they recover the parachutes, they said.
Yeah, no, sure. But there'll be material leaking.
There's a freaking flag.
What the frick? Oh my god. Somebody's so triggered right now. It's so good.
COVID, yeah.
They must be pretty damn close to the freaking coast. You got all these civilian boats over there.
Well, no, it's in the Gulf of Mexico, which is quite ambitious.
Those little whalers can fucking cruise, buddy. They can cover some distance.
Yeah, there's a guy. He's adding the freaking cables and stuff or whatever.
They're gonna check the astronauts first.
You think so?
They're not gonna open a freaking hatch in the water.
Why not?
Because Gus Grissom did that and he lost the fucking pod.
They do that eventually sometimes. I'm not sure what they're gonna do here. Are they gonna pick it up?
I thought that was what they were explaining.
They're supposed
before.
To use a crane to pull up the top piece.
I would assume that they're going to secure it before they fucking open anything, but we'll see. This is going to take a little bit.
The Apollo used to put a ring around it, and then they came out and sat in the ring until...
Just put a ring on it, and then...
The helicopters came along and picked them up.
NASA greened out their processes a bit, you think?
Yeah.
They have
you seen a rocket launch and how much fucking shit get spewed out of these fucking rockets into the atmosphere?
It's water, though, isn't it?
Yeah, but like it was worse in the past.
At the launch pad, it's steam, yes. But I'm talking about watching all the fuel get burnt as that bitch gets velocity.
There's no way around it so far.
There is a way around it. It's stay the fuck on Earth. Fuck Hell Mars. No. You're Hell all no. dead. It no. doesn't matter.
No, we need to get off this fucking rock as soon as possible.
Not in our lifetimes. We're going to be the ones that fucking die.
Yeah. If we want to survive, we need to get off this goddamn rock.
I don't necessarily want this race to survive. It's too dangerous.
At what point did the grand scheme of the cosmos depend on the survival of the human species?
No, it didn't. Doesn't it? We need to survive.
The moment we were born. See, we are the center of the universe. You see, you talk about this.
You can check a map. We're in the middle of it.
Yeah, you know, we were the center of all the planets and the sun.
Everything is around us.
Around us and everything at one point, right?
Yeah, that's why we're
finding out that's not necessarily true. That
we're so far out on the
Big Bang happened right here.
We're like just hanging out in one little arm of some little tiny speck of fucking dust in a mass of specks of dust. And we aren't even the size of a speck of dust. It's amazing.
Do you ever see that that comparison where they take Earth and then they show it next to our sun, then they show it next our sun next to another sun next to another one? It just keeps getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and we finally just like we kind of like disappear after like the third or fourth sun.
I don't understand it's why these such a low
and they keep going radio. And then it's horrendous, and they keep going until they get to the largest star, and the largest star compared to our sun is just like Earth to the sun.
It's amazing how large celestial objects are.
Oh yeah, and we can't even imagine it. There's no word to describe how gargantuan.
We can't even compromise. We can't even.
I keep it up there, really.
See, you know, imagine what the Earth is like in its fullness. It's like it's so hard for people to You still got
like
people
thinking
that the world is freaking flat, right?
Yeah.
You know, you can't conceive, you know, how much distance you actually have to travel to get from where you are all the way around and back again kind of scenario.
Well, start walking.
Fuck that. There's too much water in the way. I can't swim that far.
And on this speck of dust in this gargantuan size universe, a small group of people are moaning over a stupid game called Star Citizen.
That's a hell of a segue.
Well, when you said a speck of dust and you know how irrelevant we are, and on that speck of dust is, you know, a group of people who are actually going ape at the moment over a game.
They're always going ape over the fucking game.
Well,
what did we discuss before? People need purpose. When there is no purpose, they will find a fucking purpose.
And they will reach.
And if that is their purpose at the moment, that is what they will do.
But look at all the boats.
Like we were talking about earlier. Yeah.
That's a lot of boats.
And those are mostly those are all civilian boats.
There's the recovery raft.
Yeah. There's a lot of civilian boats close by.
It's close. She's backing in nice and slow. Don't want to bump that fucking
beep
capsule.
Beep.
Yeah, exactly. Beep. That'd be some shit. It'd be pretty loud out there.
That's nice.
It looks like they're getting prepared to attack the.
It looks like a giant fishing trawler.
Yeah, that's all it basically is.
It's probably the similar ship to what they use to lay down cable in the ocean.
Maybe.
It's just a different rig.
Yeah.
Real low deck and shit. Nice day for it, though. The seas are pretty calm.
Yep.
That's why they...
Gotta wish they had better video. My God, it's terrible.
They probably will have in the...
They should buy a freaking webcam.
Probably I know. Better. All you need is a fucking Logitech webcam.
It's just a downlink that's terrible. I'm pretty sure that whatever they recorded will be better.
Didn't he freaking just put a bunch of satellites up there for 5G Wi-Fi internet shit?
The airplane is hovering above too, but yet that thing has a terrible resolution too.
This is what all military / government bullshit looks like.
They would be like, they're gonna land in a dark spot of connection. We won't do it because then the fans cannot watch us. Of course they won't. They won't care about the connection there, as long as they can, you know, communicate.
See, I think there's people on the pod now. Is that a dude? That's a dude.
No, there's a diver on there. Yeah.
Yeah, there's a diver on the pod. Yeah. Okay. That's what I thought.
The rescue boat is going around.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. There's always one that pops up and looks in through the window going, you know, giving the
sun. Hi, guys. Welcome home. Snowflakes.
Yes.
Not
yeah, well, welcome back to the virus. Yeah.
And they're in that pod right now going, is Squadron 42 out yet?
What do you mean it isn't?
I'm going back.
You need a roadmap of a roadmap.
What the fuck? It's good coffee.
Welcome to the NASA's roundtable.
So, do we talk about the roadmap of the roadmap?
I want to see this fucking capsule get put back on the ship. That's going to be way more exciting than anything that happened in Star Citizen in the last fucking while.
Imagine to pull the ship and it was so heavy.
The underwater roadmap. Exactly, Kemi.
I need to grab a tab from my browser. Hang on. You don't want to see that.
No, you porn on Twitch, dude.
No, they're gonna ban me, right? No. There, that's better. So what was that? Was that Tyler?
About
on Spectrum?
Oh, it did. Yeah. He I'm very disappointed actually in that reply. It was so mediocre.
That wall of text that said absolutely nothing.
Nothing. It was.
Yeah.
It was.
That's what I got.
It was lame. I'm sorry. I just have to say it was lame. Lame as you could get.
It was kind of a cop out, actually.
Yeah. It really was extraordinary disappointment. I don't know where to even begin with this.
It's only disappointing if you let it disappoint you. It's par for the course.
Are we going to get copyright flagged because we show...
Elon
Musk
this,
video?
I don't think
the automated system works that way because this is a live cast and no.
Yeah.
Look at that's one of the monkeys.
It did that last week though because
right up that fucking.
We had showed a short clip of.
No, he swallowed
Interstellar. No, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
And that was flagged.
Really?
Yep. It didn't limit the video on its own. That was a piece of music that was in the background that did that. But
if you had the audio,
Interstellar
then,
was flagged.
Just for the video.
Yeah, the video material. Obviously,
that's interesting to know. I didn't know they could do that.
Oh, yeah, okay. they could do that even before. I think long before they had the audio thing back in, because that's what people first realized that. With Disney back then, is that even if you have a second or maybe a couple seconds of video material owned by Disney, the whole video will be blocked. Disney is like that. I'm pretty sure they still are.
Oh, they're very protective of their IPs.
Yeah, but it was okay. That was disappointing.
God forbid you don't make any profit off of our material.
Because we would have been showing other things like the black hole, for example.
That's an easy.
It's like they've done this before.
It is. It's really? Like they trained.
So but imagine what they have to go through just to land back on Earth. Imagine when we can do half of what you can do in Star Citizen in the future.
Yeah, dude, but the problem is that I've been imagining that for quite a while.
Yeah, but fuck off. I'm not talking about the game.
So am I. So anyways, now that the capsule is secure, what were you saying? The roadmap to a roadmap? What is this now?
Trying to find it. Let's see.
That's what everybody's turning it into that are bitching. Saying to
well, come on, man. Didn't they say like a long time ago that they were going to rework the way that they present the information for Squadron 42?
Yeah. And his
you would think we're under like a global pandemic or something and nothing's getting done.
He said, look, we've been having issues. It's not meeting our quality expectations. We're not there yet.
Well, give me a break.
Okay.
Oh, look, it's moving.
No big deal. And they've gone down this road before. Who cares?
People. Well, they're always going down the same road, really. They hype up things. They put them on the roadmap. Then
they didn't hype it up.
They were on time.
All they said was, hey, we're working on a video. All they said was, we're working on a video for Squadron 42. That's all they said.
No,
they didn't put any timelines.
They said they didn't say the roadmap down so that they could rework it into something that actually meant something.
Yes.
And this is way long ago, like maybe fucking February, maybe
March, I think.
Yep, they did. But this write up here is more about the video that they didn't create, which people they said, hey, yeah, we were going to release a video for Squadron 42, but we haven't done it. That's all they said. And then now everybody's like, where's this video? Where's this video? Well, why isn't the video here? Where's the video? I want my video.
Standard.
Can I ask you a silly question?
Sure.
What the fuck is this video talking about?
Oh, fun.
People were bitching about there not being a roadmap update for Squadron 42. And the response to that roadmap update and generally to people being quote unquote dissatisfied with the way that CIG is handling shit, according to some people on the fucking internet, this was the response to it. And we were going to make a video, or we made a video to show the current state of Squadron 42, but it kind of sucked, so we're not going to give it to you, is what that fucking article says.
Good.
How do people get to the conclusion that it's a roadmap of a roadmap? Then
I don't fucking know. I didn't read it.
It's a post that shows them how they're working.
Someone
towards
just latched
the new
onto
roadmap,
the terminology.
That's not a roadmap of a. Okay.
They said, "Oh, this sounds really cool. Roadmap to a roadmap, and let's bitch about it." And everybody jumped
now,
on that bandwagon.
Yeah, everybody jumped on that bandwagon. And now even the mainstream, the internet gaming media is using that. Because I recently saw that a news article in some feed. It was like, Star Citizen Squadron 42 roadmap.
Yeah, look
at
how burnt that is, dude. Did you see that? Mm-hmm. Wow.
It's alive!
That thing's pretty burnt. That's crazy.
Well, no, it's actually, it's not bad now, really, if you consider how hot that would have been.
That's crazy.
How fast does
that? I don't want to do that.
Cool down, though.
Oh. Well, when it hits the water, probably fucking instantly.
It'll cool down, but it goes pretty
pumping,
fast and pretty fun.
I think they said they were pumping nitrogen.
It'll buff out.
Along the outside, the inside and the suits to keep them all cool.
Oh, really?
Because it was getting that hot.
Hmm.
Yeah, Kemi, I agree. I think that there is a lot of clickbait bullshit going on again. You know, somebody dropped.
It was kind of a roadmap of a roadmap because they gave steps of how they were going to deal with the roadmap in future. So that's kind of the roadmap of the roadmap. It was exaggerated. It was exaggerated.
It's something that they fucking have had in the back of their mind. They just decided it wasn't important to communicate with the people paying their paychecks.
But this is the problem. This is they're not communicating with the people.
They're not.
They're not.
So this is so not an issue at all.
No, it is. I think
it's a non-issue.
No, it's not a TO. They haven't properly communicated with us for a good while now. Now, I think CIG completely regrets.
We should go,
this open development thing.
If that's the case, we should be throwing a riot with what is that company that's making Cyberpunk 2077? Because they haven't said shit.
I don't know.
They just say it's delayed.
We got some shit. It's delayed until November. Fuck off.
But they haven't got anywhere near the level as we have. So,
but they were never open development.
No.
Yeah, it's true.
Quote unquote, air quotes, open development, whatever that means. Nobody really knows. It doesn't mean shit, I guess. But
we're looking for any kind of feedback. And this whole thing about the video wasn't of quality. Okay. Well, just give us some in written form. You know, we don't mind that. We do get a newsletter that people
every
seem
month
to get.
Every month they give us an update on Squadron 42.
But people
and the PU.
But the problem with that is it's very similar to the Squadron, or not the PU update.
And what difference does it make? It's still
an
update.
Copy paste the PU.
They still it doesn't matter because they're one and the same. They use the same technology. So again, they're giving us the information. People just don't want to read it.
I don't know, because the people that actually read that shit are on the internet kind of complaining about it too. So
I do read it and I do complain about it.
It's a lot is duplicated.
Same technology, same game.
Mm. Oh my god.
Yeah, but that's the issue. The technology isn't here to, to release the game.
Are you going to put dynamite in the door to blow it off, Ernie?
There is a fucking fundamental problem. And that is, like Kimmy is saying, there is a lot of money that a lot of people put out and they just want some clear and concise fucking information. That's all. Nobody's asking for spoilers. No. Nobody's asking for shit. They're asking for better information than what they're getting. There's $306 million of other people's money. And when you start appearing to take that for granted, it rubs people the wrong way. But it could be
there yes, but there's a side note to that, or a counter, which is there is the consideration. We're saying we've given you money, can you please give us some information, right? But there's the other side of the coin. The people they have that haven't bought the game yet. For them, it's debatable how good of that, how much will this information benefit new sales. And for better or for worse, new sales is what's going to make or break the game, not us. We're just here to fund it temporarily until it gets off the boat.
Right. Absolutely. Every computer, every monitor, every bit of software, every light bill that has been paid, every rent for office space that has been paid is on all of us.
The early backers, the not so early backers, and the backers in the middle, the ones towards the end is where the, it's like a tree. We are the root of the whole thing. But
the fucking problem is pretty simple, right? People want to feel appreciated for the contributions that they make to anything. And some people obviously don't feel like they're appreciated. I really think it's that simple. Some people don't care.
I agree.
Like Innovis doesn't care. I don't care. He'll just tell you. It doesn't matter. They're making the game. Back the fuck off. Okay. Well, some people want to feel like, hey, thank you very much for giving me a job and buying me a computer and fucking all this other shit and whatever. Here is some shiny shit for you. And I guess you can argue back and forth what is and what isn't good enough. I don't know, man.
I think it's a matter of what you feel is enough, right?
It's a matter of what they've done and said in the past compared to what they're doing and saying today. And it still seems like we're on like this downward slope of information and content provided by CIG. Now, I get
this,
it.
This is true.
Home, blah, blah, blah right now. But the content that we used to get, let's say starting from Wingman's fucking hangar, as horrible as that was, through 10 for the Chairman and all the other iterations of shit that they provided, to what we get on a regular basis now, the stuff then, although may have not been accurate, was better for the community because it was something.
Yes. Better for the community that was already there. But it lacked profession, you know, it lacked some kind of...
Sure, it made them look like a bunch of fuckwads sitting around drinking rum and shit all the time. That's true.
That's what people liked about Wingman's hangar, is that they're all just goofing around half the time.
And we're like, hey, they're real people just like me.
Yeah. But here's the thing, right? So this week they showed us the video with the rock. They showed us the videos about the explosion. They showed us what it's going to take to close out Stanton. They showed us Orson, and yet everybody's bitching and saying it's not enough.
It's not enough. You know why? Because no one has a fucking purpose right now, because they're all locked inside their goddamn houses, or when they go out, they got to wear a mask. That's why. Why do you think people are burning fucking buildings down in the United States right now? Because it's not because they're pissed. It's because they're fucking bored.
No, it's because Squadron 42.
But they were just morons.
And they clearly,
it's because Squadron 42 update isn't fucking happening, and they would all be pacified if we could just get it.
Exactly, yeah.
Oh, no, so Dirk's response is, it's because it's all stuff we already knew about. Yeah, but I didn't remember seeing all that new footage.
So it's just footage.
It's okay if it's something that we know nothing about.
That would be cool.
It sucks, and and they're not communicating with us if they show us updates on stuff that we already know. Is that what you're saying?
Well, these aren't really updates, though.
And the thing is, with this particular thing, well, though, with the rock, I still don't understand why they threw it up on the PTU for Evocati before anyone had ever heard about it. Obviously, it's going to get leaked. Obviously, people are going to know about it in that way. So why didn't they just throw it up on the pledge store to begin with before that happened, then sell it, and then people would be able to play it when the patch would go live?
Because I think they were waiting for our feedback before they fine tune it.
But it doesn't matter, though. They can still sell it. People would buy it. Even if they don't immediately have access to it.
Yeah, I understand, but they decided to go when it's live, so it's ready.
And
it's no big deal.
I do think that them showing us how explosions work qualifies as an update, because they're showing us how they use the tech.
Kaboom.
Kerplow.
A lot of problems at the moment. It's not right now. You can't pick all the pieces up.
I think Dirksy is onto something, although unwittingly. He says, do you think showing us ship explosion qualifies as an update? If you go back far enough, showing us anything was a hallelujah moment.
Not anymore.
we are expecting the sky to fall in our head every goddamn time they show us anything, and it doesn't. It's like a fix. The first fix gets you to heaven, and all the time the next one is not taking you quite enough there, and the next one even a little bit more or less.
Chasing the dragon.
Hackers are like drug addicts?
Yes.
No, actually,
he's made a correct analogy there.
Not getting as high as I could say that.
Exactly.
But
you're not getting the endorphins from the excitement of the new stuff that you used to get.
Yeah, though I do feel like in some cases it's also a matter of perspective difference between the development team and us. And they may feel something like that tiny little thing that they created as a big accomplishment. But for the game itself, when it encompasses as you just play the game, that single feature that they may have taken a long time making doesn't really...
For the players,
it doesn't really matter that much. I mean, it's not... It's just a difference in how you see it. And that sometimes in these videos, that's kind of the problem.
Are you guys watching this video here?
Yeah, yeah.
It's fantastic.
Do you see where it hits the man? And I'm not happy with this, where it doesn't do anything to the player. I'm not happy with that at all.
You want him to
pull
his arms in?
That's how bad he said that was intentional.
But it's disappointing, I think, that should hurt the player.
Because that
this is a tractor beam.
That's what everybody wants to use it for, is for
it's buggy a bloody laser. What do you expect? People.
No, it's a tractor beam.
It's a tractor beam. And like,
well, even if it's a tractor beam, it should suck him in.
Yeah, but like, we've been waiting on tractor beams for, like, I don't know, 6-7 years now.
Well, they've had it, though, with the Prospector, so.
Yeah, but like, we still don't have it on other ships, which were.
Nope.
Like.
That is not the true functionality, though.
Yeah, we can make use of them, because when you blow up a ship, there's like, if it has cargo in it, you get like a bunch of boxes. But to pick them up, you need to go out and pick them up one by one and put it in your ship and go and sell it to make money for, you know, for the piracy.
Yeah, but not all ships are going to have tractor beams. They've already said that.
Yeah, but like, no ships have tractor beams right now.
Oh, you mean like the Caterpillar that's been out for like fucking 4 years or some shit?
Yeah,
like
Cutlass, Caterpillar, 315P. I don't know if you guys remember that.
God, Dirk is my favorite. And they say the development team isn't comfortable sharing our progress at this time. That is a little concerning. And I have to say, yeah, a little bit. That's pretty. It probably wasn't worded quite as carefully as it could have been, because that kind of sends not a great signal. We're just not comfortable sharing our progress because we don't have any progress, or because your progress is fucked, or what?
Or because we're drug addicts that can never get enough. So they're trying to up the fix for us every time they show us. They have to wait longer and longer to be able to give us anything that resembles a fix.
Here's my perspective. I believe that most of the OG backers understand that Star Citizen as an MMO is going to take way longer, because it has gotten way more complicated. Therefore, the focus has kind of shifted to what is the status of the single player game, because that in theory should have been easier, and in theory is where the bulk of your revenue is going to come from. That's going to help you create the actual game that we want to play for the next 10, 15 years or whatever. Why can't we get information at a root level of where the hell is, where are you at? What stage of development are you at? Because you don't want to tell us it's going to take another 2 years, because that's what speculation is going to breed.
Exactly. So we need things like, where's Vulcan? Where's Oikash? You know, server side.
Vulcan.
And as soon as they give dates, everybody gets bent out of shape.
It's nothing to do with dates. It's just progress. It's just progress, Mark.
How do you measure progress?
I don't know, 30% done, you know.
Oh, yeah, okay, 30% done.
It's something. It's something.
How much?
To say, you know.
Have you seen how people react to the roadmap when they get they're at like 5 of 8, or how when your M50 was out there and it was 0 of 8, and we were waiting and waiting, and we just kept seeing issues being put out there,
and it got pushed back again and back and back pushed, back
right?
Yeah.
And then
came out, and I'm happy.
And what about the Merchantman? I mean, not the Merchantman, the Mercury, right? The Mercury right now, it started at 99, it was at 30 something, and then now it's at 115 or whatever.
Yeah, and
how
do moved
you
down
report
several
that
weeks?
Without people? Yeah. How do you report that kind of stuff and not have people get bent out of shape saying you're not telling us what's going on?
It's better. It's damage limitation. It's better.
Obviously, it's not, because people are still bitching.
It is. People always bitch. You know that.
Because they overanalyze that shit.
It's
and they
start
making
limitation.
These graphs between
Give
the
some
differences.
Little information is better than nothing.
You get 5 idiots bitching or 50,000 idiots bitching.
Something
which
is better
worse.
Than nothing. Yeah.
Right. I kind of agree.
No,
but the problem is, they're never going to be honest, and I think that the expectation of them to be honest with the backing community is probably a stretch. They're never going to tell you that they have problems. 40% of our staff is sick with COVID, so they're not working. Nobody's going to say that. Never.
So, Stevie, Madman, right? So he's saying, on the Crusader Dive on Friday that they were talking about the Cloud Tech like it hadn't even started. The Cloud Tech, they've been working on the Cloud Tech for, I don't know, I would say
5 years
now, right? And they're they've been trying to get the Cloud Tech to work where they can use it in space and stuff like that, right? Around the rest stops, right? They just haven't started applying it to the Crusader and Orison area. So, I mean, it's just they're fine-tuning it, applying it in space, which is even a bigger area than Crusader, so that they can figure out how to probably do it in Crusader.
No, my precious Idris. No.
Idrises.
No. Idrisai.
And the multitude of explosions was pretty cool.
Yeah.
The whole war, the whole freaking quantum engine warping the back of the ship and then blowing, that was freaking cool.
I can just see my FPS tanking with the...
I'm going to totally tear that apart real quick and say that each one of those explosions, while they were different, just watch it until the end. Because they are different. But when they go catastrophic, it's exactly the same.
Because they have the same power core plant.
Yep, all three. One, two, three.
Big disc, four, big four. Disc, big disc, big disc, big disc.
It's a power plant.
I think they need to rework that and add more diversity and variation in there. So it doesn't look the same, because that's immersion breaking.
That was slow though. That will, you won't be able to see that in.
No, it's going to happen way fucking faster than that in theory.
Oh no, it has to be slow.
But we already saw it, and we already know that it's exactly the same explosion, and it's going to break our immersion, so they have to change it.
And it's going to be slow. It has to be slow.
So the explosion itself are slow, but the warnings and all that stuff will probably be more drawn out. So you have to separate between the different damage states and the different explosion that's going to happen across the ships without blowing it up. But there's a difference between your single seater blowing up and a 50-man multi-crew ship.
Well, that was a catastrophic failure of the ship, and I would assume that not every fucking bit of damage is going to be catastrophic failure.
Exactly.
So, I don't know. Is that the explosion we need in Squadron 42, Kemi? How do we know? How do we know that that's not an explosion for Squadron 42?
Of course it is.
Maybe it's not. We don't know. You know why? Because they won't fucking tell us. Because fuck you and your Squadron 42 roadmap. And that's what we were talking about prior to the show. I think CIG would be better served, honestly, to just tell everybody, just fuck off for a little while. Just go fuck off for a little while. Stop asking for fucking updates. We're not giving you a Squadron 42 update. The potential for spoilers is too great, and Chris doesn't want to do it, so fuck off.
Go outside. Get some air.
Right. Go get some COVID.
There's air.
Go
pick it up.
Yeah.
The issue with Squadron is, like, most of the tech that's going to be in Squadron is already in PU. Like, we have the ships, the weapons, the flight, the combat, the infantry combat, and they're not production quality, right? They can put these in game. Like, they need to work on these at least for a year or two to get them where they need to be. Like, we had like Teeters of War, but they didn't release it because, you know, it wasn't good enough.
And it sucked.
It sucks. And the same thing goes for Squadron. Like, the AI doesn't work. Like, at all. Like, they just put Bartender in it.
At all.
14. And it gets bugged and stuff. Like, how are they going to put, like, all the NPCs in Squadron and make those work? They're using the same tech. And, like, combat and the interface, it's not working. And, like, the combat's going to be, like, single-player Wandel Swarm. and Squadron, it's not going to be any different. You're going to play against the same AI and same ships.
Or, no, because you know, in Squadron ships. 42, they actually put things on rails because it's a single player campaign.
Some of it.
So it's entirely like the PU, where the PU, they have to think kind of.
I was talking about Arena.
And they have routines and schedules and stuff that they have to follow. PU.
I was talking about Arena Commander and ship-to-ship combat. It's going to be pretty much
You're talking same. AI.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm responding to.
Yeah, like
yeah, but they're going to put the AI. Same AI in. They're not going to script combat. They might script, like, you know, NPCs. They might script, like, dialogues, which they probably will. But, like, combat, it's not going to be scripted.
It can't be scripted because it's a you can fucking fly anywhere and the NPCs need to react to what you're doing as a pilot of a ship that can go fucking in any direction at any time.
Yeah.
So same what thing you goes see in Arena Commander is a direct representation of what you're going to see in Squadron 42, guaranteed.
Yeah, and same thing goes for infantry combat too. Like, if they're going to spaz out in PU, like they're going to spaz out in single player too, it's not going to work.
The only thing that you can negate from that is the network issues that we know that we're seeing.
Yeah, but like single player WandaSwarm, there are no network issues.
Right.
They're hosted on your system. And like you get rubber banding even on that right now.
Do you?
Yeah, you do. And like I talked to Yogi Klatt about it. He said like it's a network thing even on single player. So that's an issue.
Huh.
Well, no, you see, it's the thing about the single player is that you're still on a server. You're just not.
You're
still on a, you're in an offline mode where it's just you.
Well, yeah,
but
registration and stuff, they're better in offline mode. They're, it doesn't feel like you're on a server. It never does. I don't think you're on the server. I think they're hosted on your system because, like, when you get like 5-6 spawns, like your computer, like mine spazzes out for like a second before you know it. It starts working properly after the spazzing out. Well,
you're comparing all of your experiences in Squadron, in the PU, Arena Commander, Star Marine. To a single player campaign that's run on your client, and we're not playing on a client, we're playing on a network, on a cloud-based server with client updates that gets the information from the server. So you're trying to compare apples and oranges.
No, I don't think that's what I'm saying. I don't think you're connected to a server on the offline mode.
And in Squadron 42, in theory, you won't be connected to a server.
Yeah.
No, in offline mode, you are connected.
You're still connected to a server.
Scorch, no.
I don't think so.
There is no offline mode in Arena Commander and stuff like that. It's just that you're not letting anybody else come in. Unless it's your friends.
Like, it doesn't work like that, though. Like,
registration
is always better in single player.
Huh.
That's because nobody else is spawning in.
But that's not the same.
It doesn't have to share all of that information.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. You can do multiplayer as solo too, and the experience is worse. Like when no one joins in your server, you can play it as a solo, and it's not the same. It's way worse.
I still don't understand what you're saying because you're trying to correlate. Playing
you can
Star
do
Marine
multiplayer
and,
solo,
and,
or you can do single player, and they're not the same experience in Arena Commander. They're different. Like in single player, you register your hits, and it's like it's the best space combat can be in this game. Like it gets worse on multiplayer and on Arena Commander, and it gets way worse on PU. You know.
Okay.
So.
I would believe Bright because he actually plays it. Innovus.
Yeah, no, that's why I stopped because I'm like, well, I'm not playing it, so
from my experiences, I'm convinced that offline mode, you're still connected to a server. It's just you.
But you can play without a connection, though. Hopefully,
well,
we'll get that. What was that game? Diablo 3 all over again. Like the shit when they launched that, like you had to have an internet connection to play single player.
If you're
like, 100%
sure, 100% sure that you're offline, then just turn off your internet, unplug to the router, and if you're still able to play,
we'll test that at some
point. Well, we'll test that, but like if they got DRM for it.
What was it, SimCity?
It won't work.
That claimed, SimCity claimed that the computing power needed to run all the calculations to run such a city were required a server on the internet to calculate it for you, and you couldn't do it without an internet connection. But that was a load of bullshit to begin with. Remember that one? That was hilarious.
I can play City Skylines. That's doing way more calculations than SimCity. Totally offline.
Someone disproved it right away because they tested it with some adjustments. They had tested it in actual offline mode, and they could still play it.
Yeah, like people spawn ships in solo mode or modified games. Like they mod the game files and with the leaked skies and stuff.
So
what else did we? Yeah. Actually,
Orison. Might as well have a look if they show it off.
Which won't be this year. That's all they said. It won't be this year.
Yeah, it looks like Q1, Q2.
Maybe.
I think they're too focused on Pyro.
Well, Pyro hopefully they're too focused on fucking Squadron 42.
Well, hopefully. But Pyro should be easier because there's no main cities like you have in Stanton. The only thing big should have been the Gold Horizon station and various different outposts dotted around the place, but they're all small.
Okay, so they showed some like weird ass white box shit with a character walking around in what would theoretically be Orison.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think that's new?
No, that's been around for a while.
No, that's new. That was new what they showed. What are you doing? Well, not the picture.
Well, it's not in here. That's why.
It's in the video.
It was in like the ISC or whatever.
Friday show.
Inside the calling all devs.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
Towards the later half, towards the end. Because, Jared kept trying to get the guy to talk about it, but he kept going off on his tangents about Pyro and other kinds of stuff instead of talking about it. He finally had to tell us about Orison.
Is this old, or is this white box of the new shit?
No, this is new. This is brand new.
No, this is new, but they have been making this for a long time, though, because the picture that I just showed earlier was from some sneak peek from like last year or something like that. They have been doing this.
The last time we had the roadmap card on, they're about halfway done.
I'm pretty sure that a lot of the structures that you see here were already done.
See those two Star Runners up there?
Yep.
That was cool.
So, I look forward to this. I really do.
You're saying the biggest challenge with this place is that there's less walls. It's all open space.
Yes. So this could cause problems with the FPS.
Like that NPC walking over the edge and falling to his death.
Did you say could cause problems? Are you crazy?
Will cause problems.
Will cause problems.
But there's just empty sky out there. So
this is
it's not like there's a render of the planet below. Not much, at least.
This is why they were talking about a system called Monster Closets, where NPCs can spawn and despawn out of the view of the players.
Instead of NPCs just popping up in the middle of a fucking
walkway. Is it their mascot?
This is their mascot. I love this one, brilliant. Better than the penguin.
I don't even see. What is that? A whale?
It's a whale.
With giant eyeballs?
Yep.
With a big horn and then his nose.
Well, actually, that's the...
I don't know. It's not.
Whatever the structure from the fountain or whatever it is that's protruding through it. It's a door wall.
And then that next to it is the dry docks. So you can see some Crusader ships there.
They said something about Gas Giants.
Yeah, it's a new company.
Zerk. I don't remember what the fuck Ian was talking about when he was talking about Gas Giants, but they mentioned it. And I think it's still all in the fundamentals of the cloud tech shit, isn't it?
Yeah, he was saying that they're not ready. The tech's not ready to fully implement it, but they're going to do it in stages. I think is what he was talking about.
Yeah.
It's good enough to start and then build up on it as they go.
Yeah. Yeah. I think, yeah. Because it's going to be quite difficult to do a swirling gas giant from that kind of perspective. They were talking about the images that were sent back from the Juno probe of Jupiter. Now, there really are high res, spectacular images of swirling gas. And it's absolutely well beyond what we see in Crusader at the moment. And it's quite detailed and quite difficult to do in any kind of simulation, let alone a game. The Juno probe, JUNO. And if that's what they're trying to aim at, that's extraordinarily difficult, because it really is a complicated swirl of gas and what's the word for it? Something mechanics. Fluid mechanics. I don't know how they're going to pull it off. But anyway, if they just even give some basic cloud for the time being, I'll accept.
I don't know.
That.
The community is all up in freaking an uproar because the cloud tech isn't there on all the current planets, and it's just a thin layer that you just go through in a second.
Oh, yeah. It's kind of weak.
You know? So.
But if you put
that in there, then people are going to get all twisted again.
That's going
to they're going to get fucking twisted regardless, because that's all we have to do.
So if they pull that off, that'll be absolutely amazing. It won't be anything.
Unfortunately, people are setting that as an expectation, and so they can't do it.
It's theoretically and mathematically impossible to even get close.
But people like you posting that saying, "Oh, this will be great if they can do it," setting expectations.
They talk about they use Juno as an example. So the devs actually
people like
that.
you Irish bastard. What the fuck is wrong with people?
Yeah.
People like you. Yeah, it needs to look just like that. Just like it needs. It better look just like that, or I want my money back.
Not just like that.
Every
gas giant Jupiter
needs to look just like Jupiter.
Jupiter's a gas giant.
Not all Jupiter.
Doesn't every gas like giant Jupiter. In Star Citizen is going to look like Jupiter.
You mean?
I think the size dictates the size of the gas giant dictates really much how it looks like.
If you look at Saturn, for example, another big one, it isn't as detailed, even though it does have quite similar size storms. So it doesn't have to be like this. Like the poles here, if you can see this is crazy.
Saturn doesn't have the detailing because it's just so.
Well, it has this haze layer above it all. Yeah. So I think COG would be crazy for going anything like this. It's just in the long run, it wouldn't be worth their effort unless they can pull it off.
Saturn has a hexagon at the North Pole.
You aren't going to be harpooning any fucking space whales, dude.
No, you know you've been waiting for that. I know you will be.
But, you
won't. Oh, of course you will.
Bullshit.
Oh, yeah. Hell yeah.
There could be some fucking anomaly off in the distance where you're like, is that a space whale?
I love this.
It is.
It'll probably be against the law to hunt the whales.
You can't get to it because it's
and you come down with your big ship, you know, and your harpoon it, and then it just pulls you down.
And then you just panic
because you can't get off it quick enough, and then the pressure starts increasing and your ship starts imploding. Oh yeah.
This I love this thing here. It makes you realize the size of this thing, because you can see the detailing here kind of starts to look like actual clouds as they appear on Earth. And if that was a giant storm system as it was on Earth, imagine how incredibly large the rest of it is. It's just insane.
And that's still nothing, because you can actually go right into those, and they'll be surround you like a big gigantic wall, kind of.
Right, Kimmy? Right? By the time they fucking get over there and they rework all this fucking cloud tech another fucking 40 times, it'll look just like that.
So if you can wait another 50 years or so, you know.
Yeah, it'll be good.
Mm. Well, we have had the Pluto images since then as well.
Yeah, the cloud tech, yes.
What else are they looking for?
Well, they had a weird quote, accidental, quotation marks, accidental post of the, what was it? The Tavarin ship?
Oh, the Talon.
Talon?
Yeah.
And it may have just been on purpose. I don't know.
Accidentally on purpose?
Accidentally on purpose.
That's the whole thing. It disappears and disappears just as quick.
Someone loaded up the page but didn't load it up hidden or whatever.
Not on the comlink overview page, no. It wasn't accessible in the first anyway, but at a staff level entry, yeah.
They seem to be also, they were talking about hospitals are close mm-hmm. behind cargo decks. So we know they're working on cargo decks next. And hospitals close behind. So I thought that was quite interesting. That's something new.
So that medical gameplay in 3.10.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah,
there proper medical gameplay. Yeah.
So you can bandage wounds and shit?
Well, I think if you get injured, remember they're saying that your hyperspace will only be temporary. You have to go to see proper medicals. You know. Here we go. They're opening now.
Oh, just on time.
Look at the way that door opens.
That's look, everyone's watching. Photographer.
Oh, yeah.
This oh, my God. Get out of the way, moment. Right? I want to go out.
And I hate to be the guy that has to clean that
to hold it up.
Clean it up. Yeah, look at that. It's beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah. Strip it down, reuse it again for the next mission. So yeah, that I thought that was interesting. So it could be hospitals could be closer, because I'm kind of the hyperspray thing is just a bit cop out really at the moment if you get injured, because if you got seriously injured you should be forced to go to a hospital or some kind of medical center.
Yeah,
and interrupt what you are doing because of your carelessness or maybe somebody else's who came into
yeah, well, how fucking in-depth is the current medical gameplay, you know? Do you have fucking broken limbs and shit that you could still semi-function with?
Mm.
Take some pain meds so that you can limp the fuck around and fly your ass back somewhere to get it repaired at a medical center?
Basically, I think that's what they're aiming at for this. That's what it seems to be, anyway. I don't know about anything more detailed. I don't know how detailed that's going to get now.
Yeah, a little bit more than some people want.
Oh, of course. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It's too realistic.
Wasn't Metal Gear Solid 3? Get up.
Kind of skeptical on that whole aspect that everybody's like, oh, this is going to be so in-depth and all this fucking shit. And when? Is it good? When the fuck do they have time to make anything in depth? You're still on phase two of mining. Think about that. Phase two of mining. The very first profession trade implemented and is still on phase two. And salvaging isn't a thing. Medical has been discussed for 4 years.
There's also repair, refuel, exploration.
What are they doing?
Science, farming, outpost building.
They're going to cut the camera away when they think that something shady might be going on.
Maybe.
Maybe these guys are fucking dead in there.
No, that could be dizzy. You know, you do get dizzy spells when you come down after. You know, if you're up there for about a week,
been,
and you come down.
Been up in zero G for quite a bit.
Mm. So,
and gravity, like they're like, oh shit,
gravity's a bitch.
Oh, those
feel so heavy.
Oh, you have to be sick for 4 months after. You don't see that.
Well, that depends. They haven't trained though.
No. You still, no matter what you do, just you can still be susceptible to sickness. It does take you a while to readjust.
And plus, they're on the water, so.
But that's a win.
It looks pretty calm and stuff like that. But add that level of motion.
Salvage! Oh my god! Wow! Remember Salvage?
What's that?
Yeah, Salvage. I don't know. Something tells me that's light years away. The way they described that they wanted to break down everything.
Yeah, but the thing is, they wanted in Pyro, so they got it.
I don't think
they'd just be reeling in crab that's already floating in space.
Yeah, that would be again very basic Tier
very
Zero.
Basic, yeah.
Tier Zero is supposed to be like getting a derelict ship and remove a component manually without any help from salvage ships or whatever. And
when was the Prospector released with the first implementation of mining?
Oh God.
Three years ago.
The Reclaimer was even earlier than that.
But that never worked.
The Reclaimer was put out because they needed it for Squadron 42.
Yeah.
Just
that's
the
only reason it was worked. Yeah.
They didn't actually need salvage to be a thing for Squadron 42. It was just kind of like being faked.
I think they're trying to do everything on a small scale first, just like they do in ships. Manufacturing ship brands and stuff like that. They try and make from a certain brand. They still try and make the smaller ship first, work out the ins and outs of the whole brand, and then work their way up. And they may do that with some functionalities too. Did they show that they had added or they were going to add another module for the multi-tool? So you have a cutter now. You have a miner. Did they show something else recently that you could add to it?
Tractor beam,
little track. Yeah. So you see, small scale tractor beam before they work it out on the ships.
I'm just saying, Ralum, that Dirk is saying the first implementation of mining as we know it was 3.0 at the end of 2017. We're coming into mid to late 2020. So it's been 2.5 years. It's a long time. It's a long. I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, no, it's funny it's a long how time. Everybody still assumes that that they're hoping that at some point CIG will reach a Jesus level of figuring stuff out, and then suddenly they can poop out content way faster. But can they? For some parts of development, yes, like planets and systems, but there's so much more than that.
To dragging my man out naked.
Yeah, that's it.
They're gonna put him on the cart, trolley, Groony.
My man is my legs don't work. My legs don't work, bro. I can't feel my legs.
In some cases you just see them put them in a wheelchair, but and they can still somewhat stand, but I guess it differs per person. And I guess I can't even stand.
The fucking ride down was probably hella crazy. He's like sitting up. He's sitting up in the gurney. He just gave the thumbs up.
He waves. Yeah,
yeah, put his legs up on his own. He's fine.
Oh, yeah.
So, Juntal, have you ever experienced 5 to 6 Gs?
No, probably not.
If you've been on a roller coaster, they said that it's the equivalent of the 3 Gs.
Oh, then maybe. I've been on some fucking stupid roller coasters that I'll never go on again for sure, but... They don't last as long as that fucking ride coming down from space, dude. Jesus.
Well, the re-entry isn't that long, though, is it?
If you gotta be five, six minutes.
Most of the time, they're just floating. You won't feel a thing until
But 20. Can last about 20 minutes or so.
Yeah, but the heavy turbulence like part of it.
Atmosphere. Yeah, once you hit like the fucking ionosphere or whatever, the where you actually start getting the resistance of the atmosphere.
That's probably only that's like a minute. That's
kind of scary shit, dude. Like literally shit your pants kind of stuff. Like, fuck, I hope this motherfucker doesn't turn into a candle and melt my balls.
Well, the biggest fear is, and it has happened with the Soyuz capsules coming down, that the it actually comes down too fast, and you come down at a ballistic pace, and you're hitting like 7 Gs, and you really, really feel it. So,
well, what's fucked up is that they land on land when the Soyuz they land on land, not in the water. I mean, landing on water isn't that much softer, but it eventually dissipates some of that impact. You hit ground, boom.
Well, that's
got to fucking rattle your bones, man.
Well, no, they do fire the retros at the very last second. You usually see this plume of dust suddenly appearing just before, and that isn't a hit in the ground. That's just the rockets being fired at the very last second.
Still,
of course, still if that doesn't work, then of course it's gonna be bumpy. It's a great piece of engineering. I love this kind of stuff. You have to, you know, you rely on all these systems. You rely on other people to do their job properly, and then
all this technology is going into the fucking 2025 Tesla Roadster.
Do you think that
all this stuff was automated? Almost all the whole flight was automated and carried within the ship.
Yeah, they were watching porn on their iPads. Dude, fuck. They weren't flying that shit. Oh, well.
So oh 310 well. Is looking good. It might actually come out this week. It's not a little bit more stable.
Let's put it this way. They have no choice. They have to get out this week.
Why do they have to? Please inform me.
We're already late anyway.
Yeah, because 311 is just around the corner.
They don't have to do anything.
Clap, clap.
Not according to the community.
We didn't see this. We didn't see the second guy, though. Or...
Well, I think we go back to the comment of that Dirk made earlier that technically CIG doesn't owe us a fucking thing. They don't owe us being on time. They owe us
300 million.
107 almost now.
Well, what I do wonder about seeing that this, if the quarterly of the, what was it, the Saga development thing works that way, then this delay in the 310 would mean that they start working, that possibly the one that will be released for the December will be difficult for them.
Maybe
in theory. Isn't that what it works?
No, in theory. 310 was in 6 months of development, and 311 would be in 4 or so months of development because they were supposed to do six month sprints instead of 3 month sprints.
Yeah.
So yeah, they should have already started 312.
Right. It should be starting. But who? The people who working on 310? I don't know how their staggered development actually works. So who's working on what? I'm sure they got multiple systems being worked on simultaneously, but how many people are doing what and where and for what project? No one knows.
One of the questions that they asked Todd Pappy was, how does the delay in releasing a build impact the development for the next one? And he basically said, well, they're working on the stuff until a bug gets found. Then they get pulled to fix the bug, and then they go back to doing their stuff. So it's impacting something's being impacted.
And oh, for sure.
One point or another, because we're trying to do actual quality builds and release them while we're still trying to develop the game. And this is something that I've always bitched about. I'm like, we're taking away. It's like, just don't give us anything. Just build the fucking game. Leave us where we're at.
Well, that was the argument that some of us made, but then they had that content drought years ago, and it was not good for anybody. So then they tried to rectify that by going to the 3-month cycle, and that is probably too much to ask. So now they're still on a quarterly release 6-month cycle, and it appears that too might be too much to ask.
I don't think so. I think it looks like they're getting the content out. What's killing them is fixing the bugs.
So they're not getting the content out.
Well, yeah, you're right. They're technically not getting it out because they're still working on getting the bug fixed, right? But I think that's what's really impeding it. They get the stuff done to where it's ready. They meet their deadlines, but then when they actually start putting it into play, start building, you know, putting more people on it and the loads and stuff like that, that's when all the bugs come into play, and then that's what delays everything because they got to fix all the bugs. I remember that episode or that time period where they were actually showing us how they were going through the bug reports for that one build, and they were showing, okay, we had these many blockers, this many, this, that, and the other thing, and then the next week they showed us the report and they showed how some went away, new ones came up.
Sure.
You know, that kind of stuff. That's what's killing the schedule and getting the stuff out, is because bugs are a bitch.
Well, the game is ridiculously complicated. You know, the Star Citizen Live shit is crazy complicated. There's a lot of fucking moving parts in there, so it's a given that shit is just going to break. I'm not concerned as much with, well, that's not exactly true. I am concerned with the time frame because I'll probably be dead before the Persistent Universe is actually something worth playing.
You know, there's been backers that have already passed away.
Sure.
Right? We got a space station named a spaceport Riker. Named after one player. I remember when Star Citizen was first announced, there was a couple of guys that were doing a podcast. They started off early on, and they were really into it. And it was a podcast. It was like only two guys or whatever. I forget which one it was, but one of the guys passed away probably right about the time the hangar module came out or whatever. And you know, he was really excited about the game and everything. And then of course, obviously, nobody knows about him anymore, but I'm sure there's plenty of other backers that have passed away since then. It's the nature of life. We all want it before we die, but that's outside of our grasp.
Yeah, I'm just thinking that some of the people that said, you know, it may not be doable in a lifetime might be accurate. Because there's a lot of shit. There's a lot of shit. A lot of shit that still needs to be done. Like I said, 2.5 years later, and we're still on fucking the second iteration of mining, and that's it.
Well, I think we are back to, if you remember a couple of 3-4 years ago when we talked about how should we, what was the time frame? And all we said, well, don't worry, it's coming next year. And next year I said, don't worry, it's coming next year. And eventually people got wise to that. And it's still the same thing. Don't worry, the game is coming, but not as fast as you want it. But, you know, because of the world we are in right now, it's kind of like more like, we hope it's finished. We know it's going to get finished, but we hope it's finished because before the world goes to shits.
I don't know. I think some of the argument is that what they're trying to do might be too fucking complicated. It very well may be too complicated.
I would say that the stuff that they're trying to do is very complicated, but they always seem to manage to figure it out.
Do they, though? Or is that your perception?
No, it's my...
Okay, where is Theaters of War? And how did that work out?
Theaters of War is being worked on as a secondary project.
Oh.
It's not a primary project, right? Sean Tracy has specifically said, we want to get this in there, but it's not a primary objective. We work on it when we have the ability to work on it. And it's not balanced, and they're trying to make it balanced, and they're trying to make it work.
So then you just give credence to the fucking people that say Star Citizen developers tell you what they want you to hear to get you to spend money, because they said that Theaters of War was going to be Q1, and here we are.
No, they didn't say. They said they would like to.
Bullshit.
They did not say they would. They said they would like to.
Fuck. Okay. Semantics.
Yeah.
Okay. Whatever.
People hear what they want to hear.
We're going to try to get that out to you guys soon.
That's all they can say. If they give a timeline, they're not going to hit it.
Fucking complicated for their egos.
Yeah, maybe.
That's all I'm saying. Maybe. Like Drayton said, we don't know if it's going to be finished. We don't know. It was supposed to be finished in 2016. Like, seriously.
42.
Eventually, you have to start logically thinking through things. Am I saying the project's dead? No. Am I going to jump on the bandwagon of those fucking morons that were on that Inside Gaming podcast that we didn't talk about? Who the fuck were those idiots?
Yeah, idiots.
What the fuck was the title of that trash? I got to find that shit.
What?
It was in our Discord channel, no?
Which Discord channel?
Star Citizen fans had finally had enough. Inside Gaming Daily?
Okay, yeah. And that's the fucking clickbaitiest bullshit headline I've ever... The thumbnail was
terrible as well.
Star Citizen fans have finally had enough. Hold on, I gotta sneeze.
Look at that the thumbnail was amazing.
Yeah. I just saw the picture and said, nope.
So, and then, where the fuck...
I wonder where that is in that picture, if they're rights violated.
I quoted the first opening statement of this video says, what Star Citizen fan base are rightfully and quote-unquote finally concerned about. So they started on a biased note to begin with. And then they're doing a fucking podcast on Star Citizen. And then this cunt literally says, we don't play Star Citizen. We only play games that are finished. Why are you doing a fucking podcast on a game you don't give a fuck about?
Clickbait.
Seriously, it was the most
annoying worth talking about.
Right, because Star Citizen is literally that big that they can get maybe a couple bucks out of Google Ads for that bullshit. And what struck me, and actually the games, or DG360 as he calls himself now, just did a video on this, and I pointed this out in the same thing. 15.1 million in May and 8.5 million in June for funding leads me to believe that the backers aren't finally concerned about fucking anything. That's a lot of fucking money.
Mm-hmm.
So where's the concern? I mean, I obviously have concerns, but did I stop like supporting the project? Oh, actually, I got my Drake mouse mat yesterday.
How was it?
What's it like?
I didn't open it.
Oh, that's right. You
already have one. It doesn't need.
Yeah. I keep it in the box in case, you know, maybe one day this will be like a cult classic and fucking shit will be worth money.
Well, Rylan got his t-shirt.
Yeah, the UEE Navy one.
And the Invictus one is that, yeah.
Yeah, is it cool?
The hat is still on its way. It's separated itself for some reason. I wonder if that's going to be one of those crunchy ones as well.
So, you know, I'm like, Kimmy said, what other games are we talking about? And this is pretty interesting.
Tarkov.
Okay, so.
This game.
Tarkov, right, does a podcast once a month-ish with a bunch of streamers and the lead developer for the game. And they go through the exact same shit that CIG goes through. Every time they release a patch, fucking Reddit and all this other shit blows up with, you're fundamentally breaking the game. You don't know what you're doing. You guys are fucking idiots. If you fucking don't fix this, I'm going to come and kill you, kind of shit. Like literally on Reddit, people are saying this shit about this little tiny developer for a small game. It's people are fucking insane. We're all insane.
Yep.
That was my takeaway. We've all lost our collective fucking mind.
Look at this. It's a Gulf of Mexico. These are all boats.
Boats.
And I think that's the site there on the bottom. Everybody's like, oh, brush, gold brush.
That's a pretty funny meme there. It's a pretty funny meme there.
But because it's true. We all know it's true and we gladly participate in it.
What?
The meme that he dropped.
What you doing there?
Fucking goofy. It's fucking funny though.
I like that. That's funny. People are jumping on the bandwagon again. It says, let's not support CIG. Don't buy anything
until they listen to us. Fuck these people in their fucking cancel culture bullshit.
I had a bunch of guys in the guild that I'm in were posting, I'm not giving them any more money until they start talking to us, and da 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 da, right? And a whole bunch of spot. And then I said, I'm going to continue to fund the game. I'm going to continue to buy ships. Because I don't want to be that guy that said, oh, I didn't buy the ship because I was upset and now I got to worry about getting it in game.
Got to catch them all.
That whole thread just died right there.
Well, people are rightly concerned, but like we Hamster and I have been going over for the last couple days. Just a fucking game, dude. Yep. Literally just a game.
Dare you, it's more than a game.
It's so not more than anything.
It is life.
And if
for some people it is life.
if Star Citizen, the success or failure of Star Citizen, if your mental well-being hinges on that, you are a fucked up individual. Yeah. Like fundamentally fucked up. And you need to get the fuck off the computer and go find something else in life. Because you're fucked up.
But, you know, then again, on the other side, Star Citizen has already given most of us...
Holy crap.
...something. It's giving us a community. It's giving us the base. It's given us something to talk about for the last 8 years. You know, people to play other games with. I mean, heck, we even played some Star Citizens now and then.
Sure.
Apart
from you guys, I'm over the community. I'm just done with them. I can't stand. You have the far right and the far left. You got the people that hate every last little bit of it, and you got everybody that thinks it's the God's gift to civilization. And I'm just like, I am so over the community. I don't watch streams anymore.
You guys are great. The people you hang out with, that's Star Citizen's gift to you during this whole process, And
you said bunch. Seems
keep... Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And yet we you keep coming met. Back every night.
Yeah. For more.
So you can listen to me fucking ramble on about fucking politics in America. Mm-hmm. You sorry it, son of a bitch.
It's fun. I love it. I absolutely love it.
It's good conversations. And as long as we understand that we're not solving the world's fucking problems in our Discord chats, then it's fine.
We're not?
No,
we're definitely not. We're not solving the problem with this fucking podcast either.
Well, we're finding solutions, but unfortunately we can't... execute
implement them. Yeah, implement them. Yeah, that's the thing. If the world just listens to me and does exactly what I tell them to do,
well, I get
everything
banned.
Will be better.
What if I say that Prince Andrew is tied to Jeffrey Epstein? Did you hear
no
that?
No way. Is it re- what? What really?
Or the fucking the documents were released, man. The top
oh,
secret
documents
released.
Oh, please. Give me
go look it up. It's fucking crazy shit. Prince Andrew.
I read it, yeah.
Oh, man.
That's insane.
Yeah. Didn't realize you can get banned.
No, I'm just saying, would I get banned if I brought it up? I don't
know. No.
Brett Relum is like, am I pushing the button? Am I pushing the button?
No.
Well,
no,
do you expect MI6 to come after us? I don't think
I think Relum was giving up a few years ago.
Yeah.
They'd go after somebody else before they came after me. I'm useless.
Yep.
I'm like a harmless little manat.
Manat.
Mm-hmm.
Jeez, I just had a freaking rainstorm come through this place. I mean, it was dark. It was pouring. The sun is out now, and it's all dried up. I'm like, holy shit.
And the humidity is at 105% because it's Florida.
Yep.
And the bugs that are bigger than your hand are coming out too.
What about those murder hornets or wasps?
Fuck, they've been Washington. There. That's all a bunch of bullshit. That shit's been there.
Are they like crazy. Super hornets?
They are
murder hornets.
Yes.
They're LTI.
And super huge hornets is what they are.
You know what? Anything that's humid, you can keep for yourself.
It's pretty humid in Florida.
Yeah, it is.
You should probably give it back to... Or not give it back. Give it to Castro.
Yeah, we can have it just be part of Cuba. We don't need it
Castro.
Anymore. His brother's in charge, so it's still the same thing.
Well,
post that. They'll probably release it when the... when the build goes live. Yeah. Usually that's when they release that stuff. The question is are we going to get that new ship as well?
Yeah, I say they are.
The Tavaren ship that they fucking may or may not have leaked?
Yeah. No, they said they're going to have a flyable ship as well.
What's it called? So,
Talon.
Talon.
It's supposed to be an escort ship for the Prowler?
It's a stealthy ship. Light fighter.
You guys didn't talk about the Cylon helmet.
Fuck that helmet. How many fucking new helmets do we need? No, you know what we need?
Fuck you up.
Fucking salvaging.
What you want?
Just by looking at that helmet, you will die out of fear.
And don't forget, we also have a mystery armor set coming out.
Which is probably this helmet.
I don't think so.
Yeah, it has to be. If they showed the helmet, there's a set that's going to come out.
Because then it's not a mystery anymore.
The moral of the story really is if you're not subscribed, go subscribe today. Because you have to get your fucking fancy helmet that you guys can't see, but I can see it on WeeHamster screen.
Hey, I'm pulling it up.
Well, they have the three versions, right? If you're one level of subscriber, you get one helmet. If you're another level of subscriber, you get two helmets. And then the third one, you still have to buy.
With real money?
With real money. That is the new model that they do. They put three things out. One goes to the $10 subscriber. One goes out to the $20 subscriber, and they basically get two out of the three. And then the third one you can only buy.
Yeah. Yeah. So they can get money out of everybody, including subscribers.
I don't like it.
Well, see, this is the thing I want to talk about. I've never seen a helmet that has divided the community as much as this, because there's a lot of people came out saying they hate this, and there's other people saying they absolutely love it. Yeah.
Looks like a Cylon helmet.
Yeah, it's Cylon, some say a Power Ranger, some...
Yeah, but that's great. You cannot like it. You know what you can do? I don't like it. I'm going to go fuck off. I'm literally gonna go fuck myself because
you're a piece of scum for not liking what I like.
That's how it works.
How dare you not like that helmet, you filthy fucking bastard. Whatever. I am so tired.
Everything CLG makes should be to my liking. Or how dare they make an helmet like this?
I am fucking exhausted. And so over the fact that everybody thinks that everybody else should think like they do. I'm fucking tired of it. Just stop. How can diversity be our strength?
While
you're fucking impeding diversity. I don't understand.
It's if we're all individuals.
Fuck. That's racist.
Yeah, and... Diversity.
We're all in. You're an old guy.
And I'm not.
You fucking prick. That's funny. You think that's Mandalorian helmet there? I don't think so.
Kind of. Yeah, I can see elements of it. It's a bit of everything, really.
That's good then.
I think it's good. I think it's a nice design. But
I like the pink silver one, the biggest one on the image.
Yeah, with a white on top, and the other one I think is the purple, and I think the other one is the bronze. That's a different. Was it Imperator and Centaur? Is it?
Subscribers get. Well, we get flagged now as Disney content.
Oh shit.
No, I don't think so.
No,
we'll scrub that. That never happened. You didn't see anything.
Bring up a Cylon there. Come on.
Cylon?
Who owns Battlestar Galactica? Yeah.
Nah, they don't care. That's old shit.
You want to bring up the old original Cylon? Well, no. That actually looks more like the new one, too.
But
that
the new one. No.
Across the entire, just like this
old one? Or...
Yes.
No, yeah, that doesn't look like that. No, it looks like the new one.
No, the new one, yeah.
Who do we blame for this, Jay Lee? Who makes this trash?
Well, Jay Lee is part of that group.
He is
not the boss.
He's one of the lead concept artists, but they have other concept artists too.
I thought he was the boss, but I have a feeling he might have been demoted again.
No, he wasn't demoted. He wasn't promoted to the role that Herman was. Herman was the director.
Yeah, but he was like the character art director. He wasn't the art director. Because that's
a miniature model, helmet. But you get the idea.
There you go. Yes. You know what? That's a little...
Can you not find a better model?
It doesn't have this thing in the bottom, but the...
Just let me hamster find it, because he's better at this than we are. He'll find you one. Fucking Google master.
Jesus, the Ray Force one.
That's so funny.
It's gonna give me, okay. It's a bit small, but...
That's what she said. It's a bit small, but it'll do.
It'll do. Once it gets pleasure.
It'll do, donkey.
There we go.
Yeah. He sounds just like you, too. You know that? You sound just like Shrek.
Who?
You.
Me.
A little bit.
Christ, you need a lesson into what Scottish accent sounds like.
Irish, Scottish, aren't you the same?
Yeah.
The dwarves. Of Warcraft, they speak Scottish. You know, he doesn't do that.
Shrek was supposed to be Scottish.
God,
isn't that?
I don't fucking
know.
Is
that obvious from the whole style the movie's made in?
Nothing's obvious anymore. I'm not Scottish.
What was that other Disney movie?
Detroit.
I have no culture, no history, no nothing. Just
you do. You do have a culture.
Culture Rafe. Of violence?
Far right fascism, that is.
Fucking great.
Mm.
That's it. What else is going on in Star Citizen Land? Nothing. Exactly. Nothing. 310 is not live yet. What are we thinking? Soon? For real?
This week.
They said that they were hoping it would be out this week.
Okay. Yeah. So I didn't play 3.9 or 3.9.1. So what in 3.10 am I going to be playing when I'm actually going to download this one and play this one?
You're going to electrocute people with the new guns.
Okay, so yeah. the electroshock fucking shotgun and sniper rifle.
Which is actually satisfying.
Is
oh,
it?
Yeah, it's a lovely gun. Oh, my God.
The C-54 is a nice little submachine gun.
Yeah, it's just so stable.
Let's see. You're going to need to learn how to do atmospheric.
Oh, that's true.
With some of the big ships.
Yeah,
that's going to be fun.
The targeting is going to be fun as well. You're going to have to learn that.
Yeah, the whole new targeting and UI or HUD and stuff like that is.
There's only like 50 new targeting buttons.
Mm.
Yeah. There's 50 new targeting buttons.
Yep.
Guess what we're going to do?
It looks pretty.
It is pretty, I think. But we're all going to get together in a retaliator of all ships and have fun.
And Bright, what is going to suck and piss me off in 3.10?
Don't say flight model. Don't say flight model.
Probably flight model. Yeah, it's not done.
Ship-to-ship combat, probably?
Yeah, probably. Like you're going to like snipe other ships at 1,500 meters and shooting at pits, and that's how it goes currently.
You still don't like that whole idea of shooting at the lead pips?
Well, I would like it if like we see the ships or something. Like, it's the combat is still too long range, and the vehicle experienced team developers have been stating this too. They want to move, a bit more up close, so it looks good. They want to slow it down.
So I don't understand why they don't just scale. Why don't they just limit the range of the projectiles then?
Well, they did. Like this is what we got after they limited it. But they're gonna do a pass on weapons and missiles next patch. So
they're gonna shorten the range again.
Yeah, they're gonna slow the ships down further.
That'll
reduce the engagement distances, but they're gonna work on it for like a year.
So this ties into an argument or discussion that we were having last week with Trade and you and me and about range and sensors and stuff like that. If they limit the range of the weapons, right? Do they really need to have super long scanning ranges that mean nothing? Because you guys were complaining about how short the ranges are right now. The weapons are limited to range. Does it really matter if you know that they're out there, if you gotta close in and to engage?
Yes,
well, because there's like stealth gameplay and there's like interception gameplay. There are a lot of things between scanning and engaging and combat. Like it's a whole process. They need to design for it to be fun, and it's like the networking also creates some issues with scanning. The legacy fleet guys tested it further, and they found that over 20 kilometers, the game's not exactly working with scanning. It's just unreliable, but inside 20 kilometers, it mostly works. Like, you can detect ships, and they did a pass on the components and stuff, and stealth stuff. Like, it's an early iteration, but it kind of sort of works, the stealth. Like, you pick out stealth ships and you pick out stealth components, your signatures get low enough that you won't be detected for, down to 3 kilometers, something. You'll be detected only inside 3 kilometers, and make loops in a default loadout or something. So like there are a lot of things around this, but like back in 2.5, they said they want to reduce engagement distances. That's like, you know, like years ago, and they haven't managed to do it yet since they added cruise mode into the game. But like this again, I'm talking about like years ago. So they're gonna work on it, and we'll see what they come up with. But because if they don't reduce it, like you end up with a pip shooter, you just shoot at the, you know, elements in your interface, and that's not good gameplay. Like nothing makes much sense at that point. You just shoot at pips, and the ship with the more health and shields and the longer range weapons always wins. They're like, there's no way around it.
Yeah, that's pretty much been the gameplay for a while, though, is you, sometimes you don't even see what you're shooting at. You're just shooting at a box on your interface. Sometimes you see the shields of your opponent get triggered by you shooting at them, and sometimes you don't. You just blow them up. Sometimes you get blown up.
Yeah, like with the singes and stuff, the hitscan alien weapons, it's been pretty bad. Like, they've been trying to adjust those. People were getting hits at 2.5 kilometers, and it's like, it was bad.
You can't see shit at that range.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they doubled the distance the models show up. It used to be like you couldn't see ships out, you know, small ship at 500 meters, but now they're doubled. So you can see them at a kilometer, but like 2.5 kilometers, you don't get anything.
But that's what the... They've stopped now with the ability to take that gun off.
Yeah, they also reduced its damage or something, but there are like bugs around it, so it registers multiple hits at once.
How hard it is to see the pip in this part. You just can't see it. You can even see the way that this pilot reacts to it. He has a good aim at this point when it's in blackness of space, and he turns around and he loses the pip because he can't see it. He's like, where is it? Where is it?
Like here, it starts shooting at like 2.5, 3 kilometers, and it's you're just seeing pips at that point.
Speaking of the range, though, have they figured out a way to display at what range you can hit it? Range indicator?
Well,
that was removed since the new
targeting methodology. That's where it changes color. When it goes
from
red
to
green. Yeah. When it goes from red to green, that means it's.
Yeah, they changed it. So if you're going to score hits, it goes green, but with auto gimbals and fixed weapons. And auto gimbals also like move your crosshair and, you know, lock on the target. Yeah, this is like earlier PTU patches with the brackets and stuff.
Hmm. I know it's board gamer stuff.
Well, yes, we'll have to play some fucking Star Citizen when this 310 shit drops.
Work.
I heard that was improved and better and a little bit more fun.
They added like large auto aim to turrets, like larger than pilots. So, you know, they could score hits now.
What's nice is that the pilot can target an enemy, and all the turret gunners can actually see that targeted.
So yeah, is that part of the new targeting interface?
Yeah. Pilot can pin targets now, and, you know,
it's
the
probably
gunners can automatically lock them to pin targets using their, you know, pinning controls.
It's definitely a step in the right direction.
Yeah, they said they're gonna do like updates on it for like 3 more patches, so it's gonna take at least like a year.
So no Squadron 42 for at least like a year.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Maybe Derek was right.
What, when he said these are not good people?
Never gonna that come down.
Or that.
I don't even remember what shit he's
doing. No, not that Derek. The other Derek. Derek's murdered.
Like, the game is too complicated and he's overpromising. I mean, it's definitely something that hasn't been done in shit, and they're trying to do shit that has not been done. So it's going to be overly complicated, but I fear what a lot of other people fear, that by the time the shit gets done, it'll be dated. Is that a justified fear? Maybe not, but it's a concern.
It is, because we've seen it with Daisy. Daisy is, I think, a fine example of this. That it came out with an excellent new formula, and it was really great at the beginning. But because the developers in the studio totally dragged their feet regarding it, others copied the format and then improved on it. And so was left behind.
Right. And you're seeing so many fucking space shooters come out, you know, because of the popularity of Star Citizen. Mm-hmm. That.
But they all lackluster.
Yeah. That's the one thing I would have to agree with.
So does Star Citizen, dude.
Star Citizen.
Everything sucks.
Its current iteration, Star Citizen, is a horrible fucking tech demo.
There is no Star Citizen.
It's so. the Star Citizen tech demo.
It's a damn good tech demo.
It's really pretty, and that's all it has.
I'm going to have to disagree. Yeah.
Well, okay. It has some sort of economy loop going on in it for sure.
It's got some coming stuff. Back.
It has no replayability.
Space and planets and pretty and big.
The replayability is lackluster, but it's there.
Okay, we have to get less salty because Noobifier's here, so I don't want to give him any ammo.
There you go.
See this barman? That's racist.
Why?
Okay, this one. Because he's Irish. Why does all barman have to be Irish?
Because you tell the best stories.
That's true. We do.
And have the best potatoes and sauerkraut.
Sauerkraut.
Is that you? Cabbage. German.
Sauerkraut.
Oh, well, cabbage.
The hint is in the name.
Sauerkraut.
Kraut.
Polish people eat sauerkraut. Is that because they were invaded by Germany and they were told they had to eat it?
Wow.
It's fine. Lol. That's funny. Fucking funny.
Beer.
Oh, the new bartender is supposed to be functional, right? Is he?
Yeah, I don't know.
Not the quest giver. He's still not in the game.
Yeah, he's not there.
They have four bartenders over at Wally's, and they seem to be getting better in interacting with the NPCs and the players.
It's better. Oh. It's an improvement, but something that you would have expected years ago. I'll be honest.
Flip that glass.
Wow. That's great.
There's a delay, unfortunately, when you ask him for something and the bartender actually doing something.
The bartender.
Oh, that's normal. That's
always a delay with the back-end system.
You go to a real bar, you don't get your drink right away. Not unless you're a regular and you pay a lot of money.
There's nobody else here. It's like, give me my drink. What else can you be doing?
Noob, I think it is Star Citizen that causes the 30K. Just saying. It might be Jared. It's hard to say.
This interaction system, and we all felt like it was so amazing. How tedious it is to try and select and either one of these options with it.
The FOV on it is all fucked up. A lot of times the options are out of your fucking field of view and shit.
It's hard to get your mouse there in the first place.
And especially if you're wearing like armor, it clips into the armor, what you're holding
especially
in your hand.
With people who don't know how to play this game, you just press the mouse, the left mouse button to drink. That's all, you know, you don't need
to. So why do we need the fucking contextual menu then?
But the other options.
For so you can place it or inspect it, you know.
Like,
oh, and carry it, yeah.
I just need high keys for all this shit.
Couldn't they have just made it? I mean, I, in some cases, I mean, yes, you could. It would be useful to have the options hover over the item that you're interacting with, but you don't technically always need to do that. So instead, you could just flick it in a corner somewhere, and then at least it'll always be at the same spot.
Perfect.
Easier to select it.
Can't wait to throw it and throw the glass at somebody and start a bar fight.
Actually, in some cases, they do already get annoyed when you try and leave stuff on the floor. Like, not my job to clean this shit up.
It's not my job to give a fuck. Should have got a better job, bartender. Rip. Fucking Grizz. By the time Star Citizen comes out, I will have spent $30,000 re-upgrading my PC over and over. And I probably...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It's been early 2014. I'm on my third build. I'm probably $9,000 into building computers already. $700 or $670 or something away from $15,000 in funding. Something stupid.
I get a free ship.
That's what you guys keep saying. I should just buy one more ship. It's only $700.
Only buy what you want or need.
I need something that they can't deliver. Well, like a playable game. All right, it's 5-5. Let's get the fuck out of here. That's enough fun.
Thank God.
Enough fun. Thank God. Wow. Enough. You people are...
Well, I'm bored. Innovis is all fucking white knighty and shit. Fuck. Wee Hamster's the only fucking stable one here. Relum just wants to make fun of me because I'm old. I don't even know what the fuck's...
What? Why don't you carry me in Tarko?
Because we're going to eat.
After.
And then maybe. Well, I don't even know if we can because Tarkov has this weird problem with fucking cheaters.
Really? Like,
yeah. Remember when Star Marine dropped and there were all those wireframe cheaters and shit?
Uh-huh.
Tarkov had exactly the same issue, but on a bigger scale because Tarkov is more popular to play right now on a daily basis than Star Citizen. So In order to combat some of that shit, they've implemented ping limits where it's really difficult for people in different regions to play with each other, if not impossible. Because remember when we were playing the last time, it continuously just disconnects you?
Yeah. But we just have to pick a server between us.
Right. So we can try it after I eat for sure.
Yep.
And then we can go into the new customs area and get fucking destroyed by a bunch of fucking juicy,
but the hacks,
overgeared asshats.
Those hacks
you don't
made
don't
people. Ping. So you're saying what they did was they artificially increased their ping to teleport
some
around
of it
or something
is that,
like that.
Some of it.
Tactic we've seen.
So you could teleport.
They wouldn't be able to hit
you. It looks like teleporting, but it's not teleporting. It's fucking just not updating with the server
Light
properly.
Switch. That's so. What I was, yeah.
Yep. Same theory.
Wow. All right.
Someone's always got to ruin it.
Yep. What is the difference between a white knight and a whale? There is a difference, but generally speaking, the whales are usually white knights.
Oh, what, this is so it's not some kind of joke? Oh, okay.
No, I don't think it's a joke.
I don't know. Kemi can troll with the best of them, so maybe he has something in there.
One is a taker and one is a giver.
Lol. I don't get it.
Neither do I. Well, the giver is the whale.
Obviously, but how is a white knight a taker?
He takes it.
He takes it.
I get it. You're getting fucked. Lol.
God. All right.
Oh, that was a horrible ending to the show.
Whale Knights.
Ah, what?
Nah, it is. Come on.
Our production quality is that, fucking sucked.
That was so bad, I don't have to say anything.
No, it spoke for itself.
Uh-huh. Right?
Opie Dick. Oh, my. Here we go. It is definitely time to go.
Yeah.
Yep.
The jokes are getting stale.
That's it. That's hitting the button.
Manor.
We'll see.
Oh, don't hit the button. No. What was that movie?
Oh, it was from Rush Hour. Do you remember? Was it Rush Hour 2?
Banana in the tailpipe?
No, it wasn't Rush Hour 2. It was Rush Hour when they kidnapped the little Asian girl and they strapped the bomb on her and they were in this building and the dude has the detonator in his hand, but the bomb is too close to him so he can't push the button. And Jackie Chan and this Asian girl and Chris Tucker are like, push the button, motherfucker. And this little Asian girl's like, yeah, push the button. Push the damn button. You should get that clip because it's fucking great.
No, because it would be straight.
What?
We're just hit left, right, and center at the moment.
I guess. Copy right my ass. Ain't nobody fucking. Whatever. Anyways. I'll probably time get us go. In trouble.
All right. We'll see everybody next week. We'll be around on Discord if you want to hang out.
3.10 might be out, and we'll have a couple of ships as well. So,
couple.
Save.
I still don't know about that talent. I just don't know.
We haven't seen it yet.
Yeah. Right. Exactly.
But I can guarantee you that whatever price you think it is, multiply it by two.
It'll be higher. Yeah.
Whatever you think is reasonable, because it's divine. Not high enough. The alien tax or whatever, right?
What do you mean DMCA?
I think 150.
That's like the what they're doing with that copyright shit, right?
Yeah.
I don't know what it's called. Something about Copyright Act. Fucking bullshit.
Digital Millennium
Copyright Act. Yeah.
Fucking. That's right. Why I don't make YouTube videos, because they would all be demonetized.
Such a hassle trying to get that.
It's destroyed creativity, I think.
All right, let's go. That's a motorcycle. See you later, everybody. Till next week.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Bye. Bye.
I support the monkeys.
What the fuck?
Do you?
Goodbye.
Check out the base.
Goodbye.
24/7 online radio.
Oh, yeah.
Visit us at thebase.sc.
Goodbye.
They're professionals.
You do sound British.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Bye. Goodbye. 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 Goodbye.
It's over.
You just keep saying goodbye until
goodbye.
The screen goes off.
Goodbye.
No one's going to just leave it running goodbye. Until you stop goodbye. Saying goodbye.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye.